Ladies and gentlemen, Odisha is among the achiever states that has shown robust governance model, which is learning for several other states. The state has natural resources, the excellent policy framework, and most importantly, the leadership that's committed towards the people. So it's very apt for anyone to say Odisha is a state that has it all. When it comes to economic sector, agriculture has played significant role in our economy. The sector has developed over the years with the advent of technology, right policy intervention, innovation and value addition, and of course, changing consumer preferences. One element that is crucial is agri-logistic, and that is the central theme of our discussion today.
So yes, Milk Mantra has already created a trusted brand, okay? And it's already owned the heart of people in the state, right? So let me ask you one question. What are the challenges faced in the dairy logistics and what are your recommendations?
Forum. Now coming to Milk Mantra, as you know, we are into the phase of dairy and we are 100% B2C dairy organization. And it is true that we have created a lot of trust as well as one of the preferred brands in the state of Odisha by the consumers. But what also happens by being preferred and building on trust, we need to ensure that on a daily basis, we create integrity of the raw milk, which we are collecting from almost around 500 plus collection points, means 500 plus villages, through which we collect raw milk spanning across 11 districts of Odisha. And that creates, a very delicate balance of timing because of the bacteria formation, which we all know, which happens in dairy. And we need to maintain the temperature integrity for that. And at the same time, we need to also see that how from the village collection level, the milk gets transported to bulk milk cooling centers. And from there, it reaches to the factory gate. So that's the first leg of distribution of raw milk, what happens from the collection from the farmers gate to the factory gate. And I must compliment here the state of Odisha because I travel across villages and meet the farmers. The accessibility which has been built on in terms of the road infrastructure is really something which is commendable and which goes to the very deepest and farthest corner of the villages. And that is something which is really creating a lot of good accessibility for the farmers to get the milk to the collection points, and then the collection points it goes to the PMC points in terms of the transportation, the primary logistics. However, saying so, what I look at from the dairy perspective in terms of the Odisha can create is a very strong dairy sourcing hub, and that itself currently is a challenge. What do I mean by a dairy sourcing hub? This means that we need to have a very strong integrated logistics part, if we can create for dairy facilities, that will be a huge advantage to promote transportation for fresh milk and fresh dairy products. For example, we don't have, as I was hearing to Anand, Mr. Anand also, he was mentioning that there is a challenge in terms of cold storage logistics, right? In terms of cold storage. And dairy, as you know, is operating in the +4 as well as in -18 in frozen form, be it in butter, cheese, or milk, or powder, or the milk powder, or the fat and the cream. To that extent, right. We currently in this state, we lack this facility. So my proposal over here is if we can create a very strong dairy source hub with a logistics park in place, which can cater to this cold store management, this will be a huge bonus and a support to the dairy fraternities or the dairy organizations which are operating in Odisha. So that's point one. Point two, which I wanted to talk about, is the fleet management. Now in dairy, as we know, that all the products, be it in the raw milk or the finished products, travel into a cold chain system. It requires a cold chain movement, which is either in +4 or -18, which is in frozen form or in chilled condition. And here, the lack of availability of fleet for transporting these products is creating a lot of challenge, which eventually creates a deterioration into the quality of the finished products, or it becomes an extra cost which needs to be managed in terms of maintaining the product integrity. What I want to say here through this forum is to create a strong platform of, you know, support and incentive mechanism for the fleet providers to invest into cold chain fleets, to create refrigerated vans, and that needs to be passed on to the dairy operators, the manufacturing operators who are actually transporting the finished products. And this is something which we require as an industry to be developed in Orissa. And these two, when I'm talking about the storage facility in terms of the cold storage facility, this fleet management and creating very powerful, strong dairy sourcing hub that will create Orissa as a state, a powerful state, not only for the region of the state perimeter alone, but also to go beyond state and cater to our neighboring states of Chhattisgarh or Jharkhand or West Bengal or in down south. So I am looking from that perspective. I am very happy also to share in this platform that we are country's number one, we are the first one in this country to introduce traceability through our blockchain management. Now, why I am saying so, this is an extremely critical aspect in terms of creating transparency and trust across the value chain. And logistics play an important role along with the document of traceability to travel to the end point, right from the sourcing to the last mile, correct? And this is where I think Orissa should take some initiative in terms of creating an infrastructure benefit or transport-led incentive programs through which we can really establish a very strong traceability management, which can eventually become an export hub for the rest of the country. From here, the dairy exports can happen to the globe. So these are few of the points which I wanted to comment and one of the challenges, as well as the outcomes which I wanted to share. The fourth point is how we can create an agri-tech intervention in terms of creating a very strong logistics management in a real-time basis to facilitate right from the quality of milk, the timeliness of the milk, and the data at which we require to manage this entire. This is also all these four aspects together through this inclusion mechanism, through in terms of investment, in terms of creating this dairy sourcing hub or the logistics park, which I mentioned, along with a strong state intervention programs in terms of promoting and motivating the logistic provider to invest with a public-private participation. This will really help us to create a mega state as far as the dairy infrastructure and logistics is concerned. And before I end, I wanted to just share this and want to leave the audience with this thought by saying that, you know, sustainability also plays a very key role, you know, in logistics management. For example, we are talking about environmental sustainability. Like, for example, when we are doing this primary lake logistics, almost 1,000 plus tanker loads on a daily basis are moving in the roads, which creating pollution, which creating carbon footprints. So that is not sustainable over a period of time. Is there a way where through ASSOCHAM I can appeal that, you know, through some incentives, at least from the primary level, from the collection points of the farmer to the first level of BMC, and we have an electric vehicle intervention for which the milk cans can be collected and be put in. So this is how step by step we can build in sustainability, you know, in the entire ecosystem as well as the value, which I wanted to highlight in my presentation.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ghosh. It was lovely, Amalika. Your points are well taken care of. I believe the Mohit will take it forward to minister level so that how it can be implemented and all. So, but these all are, I mean, like whether it's sustainability, whether it's a cold chain, I mean, whatever. So it is like really, really badly needed, and it's very well thought through. So I believe that we should reach that soon. So one last question maybe to you. Does this COVID, I mean, this crisis, COVID-19 impacted anything in this business?
Of course, like any other business, dairy is also got impacted to certain extent because, cows and cattle don't understand COVID or pandemic, right? So absolutely, it is important, they will be continuously providing milk, and it is our duty also to see that, you know, how we can utilize those milk in different forms. Right. And when I'm talking right about this cold chain management and as well as cold warehouses, many of the dairy institutions are actually converting this excess milk into powder consumption. But if we don't have these facilities within the state, it becomes all the more difficult as an ecosystem to utilize this excess milk and to leverage. And this is very, very important. So that is what I want to say, like, be it in pandemic, you know, thanks that milk is an essential commodity. Thanks that, you know, the consumption was there. However, there is an impact in terms of the HoReCa, in terms of the demand. However, as I said, we need to stand by the farmers. We need to ensure that we stand by the cattle and we take those excess milk. Like, for example, we announced no milk holiday, you know, for Milk Mantra. That means we will continue to take milk. And but then we need this intervention programs to collect and store the milk during these stress times.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. Mr. Ghosh, special thanks to you. We will be in touch with you on the wonderful suggestions which you have given. Thank you very much.